Hello and welcome guys, and welcome to this short vlog. And in this particular vlog, I'm going to discuss about SPM BVM, which is a 100 marks paper in your group 4. In syllabus 2022, it is an elective paper. In 2016 syllabus, it's a compulsory paper. I'm going to discuss about both the syllabuses in this particular video. And yes, almost 3 months to go for your examination. Now is the game changer time, which is now started. And now if you study well, if you study with a strategy in mind, with a focus and a goal in mind, you're going to achieve your target, your aim, your result in a very, very seamless manner. So yes, in this video, I'm going to break down certain simple steps on how to prepare BVM SPM in an efficient way, do an ABC analysis of the entire syllabus and complete in a short period of time, revise it again and again so that you score good marks in SPM. And a rider over here. Rider is that SPM BVM is a highly scoring subject. Not because I teach it, that's why, but because it is it has got lesser of the content. It's more practical oriented and it's easy to comprehend. And yes, it will give you set off benefit. If you get good marks in SPM BVM, it will set off your score in other subjects as well. That is the best benefit of SPM BVM. So yes, SPM BVM is divided into two parts. First part is SPM, second part is business valuation. Both in 16 and 22 syllabus, the format remains the same. Okay, SPM, the first part is more theoretical. It will have almost 50% theoretical portion, 50% practical portion. Practical questions are going to come from these two chapters, which are economic efficiency, enterprise risk management. Economic efficiency, the mathematical equation questions, x square plus 2x plus 3, these kind of questions, and solving it for maximization and minimization of profit will come in this particular chapter. So this chapter is not important from a theory standpoint. You can actually leave theory of this chapter. This chapter's theory is not important at all. Okay. But yes, this particular chapter, theory as well as practical, is important. You have to do both of them. From this chapter, you just have to do the practical portion. And if you are referring to my book, this is, by the way, index of my book, which if you are referring to, then you will see this kind of an index. If you are referring to my book, economic efficiency, I've got a plethora of practical questions and practice questions which are solved. If you do these questions, there's no doubt that something around these questions will be framed in your examination. So no doubt about it. Okay, that these are the two chapters, most important chapters, from a practical and theory standpoint in SPM. Then the pure theoretical chapters, okay? Questions which are pure theoretical will come from these two chapters, and the best part is that the curriculum is absolutely streamlined. It's fenced into the four walls of the study mat of the Institute of Cost Accountants of India. Nothing is going to come beyond the institute study material. So just do institute study material well for these two chapters, and all the theoretical questions are going to come within that boundary wall. If you're referring to my book is absolutely inspired from Institute of Cost Accountants of India book. So if you are completing my book, you are completing the study mat as it is. That is the benefit. Okay. So this is your SPM portion. Now coming on to your BVM portion, which is business valuation, and 90% of your business valuation portion will come as practical portion. Okay. 90% is practical. So yes, if you want to discount the theory portions of these chapters, you can discount them. You say, sir, I don't want to study the theoretical portion which is given a merger and acquisition chapter. Don't study. That's okay. Just study the last examination question. That's it. It will be fine. 90% paper will be practical. And the most important chapters are chapter number 1, business valuation, basics of valuation model. Chapter number 13, and this chronology is according to my book, mergers and acquisition. These two chapters are most important chapter of your syllabus, guys. And for merger and acquisition specifically, a question is bound to come in your examination. In every attempt, it has been coming. Okay. Sometimes to the tune of, say, 15 marks or even 16 marks or 20 marks. That is the extent of importance of this particular chapter. So, two most important chapters, valuation models and merger and acquisition, have to be done thoroughly. In my book, there are a plethora of practice questions. Just solved or practice questions. You have to do them yourself. That's very, very important. Okay. These two chapters are definitely covering almost 20 marks out of 50 marks of this part. Okay. Next is valuation of investments, bonds and shares. Very, very important. Brand and human resources. So this is the next important part. Okay. Of course, goodwill gets covered in shares only, because goodwill questions are there in shares questions. So goodwill gets covered over there. So these two chapters are also important. You can leave liabilities chapter. You can leave inventory chapter. These chapters you can leave. These are not very important chapters. Okay, now for syllabus 2022 students, as there's a new chapter which has been inserted, which is law and compliances, which relates to the law which is related to mergers and acquisitions of India of the Companies Act. Okay, this chapter you have already studied in your law in group 3. It's absolutely the same concept over here. However, in the last examination, no question was asked from this particular chapter because it's absolutely theory, and I've mentioned already 90% of business valuation is practical. So yes, you can just study this particular chapter with a little less importance. Just go through it. Don't employ a lot of time in, on this particular chapter, and that should be fine. That should work. Okay. So yes, these were my takes or my strategy for your upcoming examination. These are important chapters, and what chapters will play key important role in your December 23 examination. That's my take on it. Please use this information wisely, and always it's always preferable to not to leave any chapter. Just have a cursory look at glance at every chapter, so that if anything comes in the examination, at least you are able to attempt it. That is the idea. So don't leave. In a professional examination, in a professional setup, you should never leave any question, and you should attempt all the questions in the examination also. Always remember this point, that you have to attempt all the questions which are there in the examination. Whether you are aware about the answer or not, please attempt it. Do attempt it, because step marking is always there. You never know when you know your subconscious brain works, and it works in your favor, and it gives you the right solution of the question. So yes, that's all for this particular session, guys. I'll be coming up with other subjects as well. The important parts of other subjects as well. You please write in the comment section below which other subject important parts do you want, and write in the comment section, yes sir, we are going to succeed in December 2023 attempt. Just write a yes in the comment section, and just give an affirmation that you will qualify CMA, and you will get those three critical alphabets CMA before your name in December 2023 attempt. On that positive note, all the very best and happy studying.